something specific. Here we go. Falling Flower, best rank, 7th in the world, and Reese, 15. We have a lot of very high-ranking players today, Stoic.
Yep, we really do, and you can see those pre-bans getting locked in right here. Wedget is going to be pre-banned, so we know about the lore. Wedget coming from Fallen Flower, so Wedget's going to get the pre-ban here. And of course, Chung Pung is going to get the pre-ban going up against Reese.
Very, very good pre-ban. The Oliver being locked in, still the priority pick in a lot of these matchups. Will he still bring the Laura without the Wedget? We know it's very strong. Maybe a Water Ryu. Oh, an early Carnal that hasn't been very effective, but maybe together with a Laura, it starts working.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. A ton of additional damage, but it also means your team's going to be pretty tanky as well. I love the double Oracle draft here coming from Ryu, so a lot of sustain, a lot of preparation. Preparation here. Let's call it preparation. And then a Juno Pra, I think these are great two picks here in response.
Yeah, I really like those picks. Some sustain, you know, and now the Riley Kinky that we've seen from Spires coming out. A lot of sustain, an opportunity to counter, you know, to bring back this match. Very tanky units. The HP lead from the Carnal has a lot of synergy into this comp, and now he goes with the double, the Teor, and the better Teor. But the thing is, if you pick a Leo, you need to ban the Leo, and then the question is, killing this Kinky might be a little bit difficult.
Yep, we'll see what happens, because I mean, we got an HP lead here for Fallen Flower and a speed lead coming out here for Reese. Of course, that Leo's going to be banned with that double Squall being drafted there. We'll see if that Squall has what it takes to take a unit away from Fallen Flower. But Reese is going to be taking first turn with a very fast Juno.
Very, very fast, and the Pra follows right after. Can he get the strips? Gets two of them. Now, does he go for the slave or does he risk it? He risks it and gets it. Now, the Oliver will have an opening. Does he go for this Laura or for the Riley? Goes for the Riley, but misses it a little bit on the greedier side. But his whole comp is so well speed tuned that the Teor has the next turn. Can he get full attack bar reduction? Yes, sir, except on the Carnal, but it's reset.
Yeah, beautiful freeze there sitting on top of that Laura as well there, so very, very nice to see that. We're looking for some more Despair Stuns, a lot of attack bar gain coming out of this Juno as well. I think the unit's focus probably is going to remain this Riley. I think he wants to try and get rid of this unit as quick as possible. You're going to see a lot of resets coming out here for the highest units. He keeps getting resisted here with this Oliver, but oh my god, it's additional turns coming up from Laura. Laura's looking to get the sleeps. Nothing's going to be happening, though.
Yeah, I would definitely use the third skill right now just to get that speed buff on my team, get all the cooldowns back, and then try to go for the kill with the Teor. He does that, but resisted on this Riley. Crits on her, but very tanky unit. The Juno coming up with a stun. Super important, Stoic.
Yeah, beautiful Despair Stun right there as well. We're going to see this third skill probably going out. It's going to choose to go to the Laura instead here. Interesting.
Yeah, the Riley gets a tech bar reset. He doesn't want to deal with a proc from that unit. And once again, the Carnal just stopped on his tracks. The Oliver with a big proc. She resisted the reset, though. We can have the opportunity of Alora sleeping and getting turns back. He guarantees that this Riley's dead with that two-turn dot.
Yep, exactly. So he's going to be getting more resets. Oliver's just been so oppressive throughout this entire match here. Juno's been getting some really nice Despair Stuns as well, but we're going to see so much attack bar gain from those first skills of both the Oracles. Almost finished off the Laura. The Taurus Squall is going to be there to drop that Laura as well. Looking fantastic for Reese.
Gotta tell you something. The Oliver has been oppressive, but the Teor on that first attack bar reduction with a freeze has been the most important turn in the whole match. And frankly, the freeze on the Kinky right now with a Skull coming up right after with lots of damage from both of these oracles has been incredible. Look at that Teor damage. What a dominant performance from Reese taking game one.
A clean, clean performance from Reese. He got his victory like he was looking for, but can he get two more?
Oh, clean. The chillest dude gets the first game. And the great, it was so interesting seeing the crit on the Kinky at the end. It's rare you get to see that sort of thing.
Yeah, it's beautiful to see the Teor as a counter to him, guaranteed crit. And the other cool thing in here was we knew that the Leo was getting banned and there were a lot of opportunities and even missing some attack bar reduction on the Riley, but he had so many ways to reduce attack bar. You know, he prepared for this. He had the Teor, he had the Oliver, and then the damage that these two oracles deal, right, Stoic? 2K per hit. That is so much. 2.3 on that Pra.
Yeah, so much additional damage coming out of both those oracles. And of course, we're going to be seeing that Oliver getting taken. There's no way that Fallen Flower is going to let that slide again. But of course, Reese is still going to be speed contesting. We've got a Moor, and we've got a Sekhmet hitting the field here.
Okay, I'm starting to suspect that him not preparing was a lie, because this looks like very good preparation. The Sekhmet coming out, very high base speed unit. If people don't know her yet, is one of the highest in the game, and it has a reset with a strip. Also has a very strong skill too that is the same one as her water sister. The Wedjet finally hit in the field, but won't have the Laura to rip off of.
Yep, let's see what happens. And he is going to be bringing out a Connell in here. I think this Connell is an okay pick coming out for Falling Flower right here. But of course, right now we do have a speed contest. I mean, we're going to be watching both these players looking to take turn one. Reese does have to lock in another speed lead though.
Yeah, I would love to see saving that for last pick. I like that. I like the Raccoony and the Miles very strong into two out of the three units. Now the question is, he has still the option even to go turn two. He doesn't need, per se, to pick that. Depends on what Falling Flower does right now. If I remember correctly, Falling Flower also has a Gianna. In this draft, not necessarily the best pick, but picks the Leo to counter the Miles and a Vert, Leo Vert. I don't know if I love the Vert and the Cardinal, to be honest. I think you can exactly pick a fire unit or a water unit last, and you don't have to be too worried. You can even ban this Wedjet and playing against this whole comp.
Yeah, let's see what happens, because I mean, I think that's definitely a fair ban. We could be seeing the Leo, but there's a world we do see that Wedjet ban as well. On the side of Reese, you might have to actually ban out whatever kickstats this whole thing. We could be seeing, like, potentially a Sekhmet ban.
Ooh, he was afraid of the Douglas. So the double trip, I really like the Douglas pick then to get away. The question right now is, can this Sekhmet land her skills? And with that, not letting this Wedjet pop off. Does he go for it, or does he go for one of the other units?
Well, he's got to attempt it here. So we're going to see that third skill going off, and he does and nail it. Majority of time when Sekhmet's able to nail that reset there, things do bode well.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if the Cardinal was the choice. You have two water units. I wasn't too worried about the Cardinal. I'm more worried about that Wedjet giving turns for his team together with a Verd. Even if you reset the Cardinal, he's going to get the turns back.
Well, it looks like Raccoony is able to resist absolutely everything right now, so a lot of damage, and he's going to be pushing all that health all the way back there. So all that work Fallen Flower put into Raccoony, it's almost gone already.
Yeah, given the turn to Sekhmet right now, we'll open up an opportunity to hit. Oh, he goes for the Miles to hit the death breaks and then the strip and damage from the Moor coming out.
Yeah, definitely could have been what's happening there. Keep in mind, though, that Wedjet's also going to be healing based off the negative effects there, so he could have capitalized off that curse of the beautiful.
Yeah.
Keep that in mind. We're going to see a nice first kill. Falling Flower's really trying to get rid of this Miles first.
Yeah, he's going great stun on the Oliver. There's a big opening right now. Damage and proc from the Cardinal. Is he turning the tides today? Two water units, no stuns, no slow. The Cardinal continues not to do anything, but the Verd is countering relentlessly.
Yeah, really is trying to counter as much as possible. I think that's what keeps Fallen Flower in this game for sure, but Reese really needs to get rid of this Verd heal as soon as possible. He's looking to land these provokes and does land on top of the Cooney as well. Second skill available, does get some defense breaks on the field.
Glancing and heal blocker, huge right here, because then what you were talking about, the Wedjet passive is not as powerful. He can get some resets right here, but this Verd will probably be off the field next turn. The question is, who can kill him? Can this Raccoony get a proc right here? A lot of damage. Can he crit? One glancing and the Raccoony survives.
It'd be really scary to go for that Verd heal. I don't think he hits that Verd heal with that Raccoony. He can't have that revenge proc coming out there. So he does choose to go for the defense break sitting on top of that Oliver. Is this going to be enough? Does he choose to go after that Verd heal with just his first skill?
Yeah, I would go for it. You got to risk it at this point. He gets the stun on the Oliver, but it procs.
Yeah. Man, proc comes out there right after that despair stun. You hate to see it.
Yeah.
More attack power reduction is going to go out on top of this Miles. Third skill is available. This could actually be enough to go on top of that Verd heal, but he is going to choose to go for the defense break and not get the strip, though.
Yeah, very dangerous moment. Now, the Verd can double crit, give attack bar to the whole team, and the Oliver's coming out. The Miles can remove him from the field. He's dead. It's a 4v3, but now the opening stands. The Raccoonie might die if he risks it. Does he go for it? Yes, sir, and gets it!
Oh, man, gets a big shot there on top of that Raccoonie as well. Of course, we're gonna see another turn coming out of this Oliver. Oliver looking to reduce the attack bar of that Miles, and we've got more coming in with an attack break. No attack break, no despair stun is resisted on top of that Wedjet.
Yeah, I think the long game right here is Wedjet's. It's so powerful with the removal of the Raccoonie. The source of sustain is out of the field, and now two water units versus a very oppressive Oliver, reducing attack bars, resetting cooldowns. Even though this Cardinal didn't do much, his supporting cast, let's call them, were extremely oppressive.
Yep, it really was. There's so much attack bar reduction, and Falling Flower is able to, you know, maintain Reese to almost not even get a turn at this point here. He's got the third skill of Connell as well. Connell's able to get the stuns and able to apply so much crystal damage on top of that. It's very, very comfortable position here for Falling Flower.
Yeah, I love his draft. It was very, very strong. And the thing was that reset on turn one on the Cardinal, I think choosing the Wedjet instead would have been a better avenue to follow.
Yeah, the Wedjet proving to be really strong and helping Falling Flower get a point on the board, denying Reese match point. We're going into a big one, guys. Who do you think is going to take this next one?
Oh, man, I really have to stay here with Reese. I feel like Reese can do it. I'm loving him right now. I love that intro video. He's just got my vote and everything right now.
Yeah, Zappy?
Well, if he gets the comp that he wants to play, I think Riz has game three, but I expect Falling Flower to adapt and instead pre-bend the Oliver. You don't want them to just keep swapping pre-bends. He knows that Riz has the first pick right now and he can steal that unit. It's been very decisive today.
Yep, definitely not expecting to see an Oliver pre-ban coming out of Reese, but I could actually see a world where the pre-ban for Fallen Flower is going to be that Oliver, not letting Reese have that.
Let's see. Yes, sir. We called it. And the Wedjet on the other side. We're going to see Laura hit the field. And the question is, does he continue to trust this Cardinal?
We'll see what happens. We've got Reese this first pick. Let's see what he chooses. Potentially take away from Fallen Flower here.
Yeah, the Water Ryu is a very strong unit in that comp as well. Will he take it away? We haven't seen much of that Chung Pung yet, but might be a good option with a pre-ban of the Oliver.
Yep, let's see what happens. First pick is going to be that more Water Ryu coming out of Reese. Falling Flower taking his time now, slowing it down. He sees the live events, guys. Mm-hmm. Laura and Sagar going to be the two units Falling Flower is going to bring here.
Sagar appearing for the first time in this matchup. Very good unit. The reset is very strong against the more, the Water Ryu that we talked about. The question right now is, does Riz bring something that counter these two later on, like a Hey Gang, you know, because you don't want to bring double water so early. But you can go once again with a Juno and maybe a Chung Pung like we talked about.
Yep. Well, there's that combination, the Water Ryu, the Chung Pung, and of course Juno. I think Juno's an excellent pick for Reese to drop in here. We saw the great additional damage coming into that unit. Used it very, very well. Falling Flower potentially looking to respond here. I think he might back it up and not choose to go turn one anymore.
Yeah, he went with the Hey Gang because he knew he could be stolen. Another thing that I would love to see here is a triple revenge Verd on Riz's side actually looks very, very good because this Hey Gang, to be honest, I think it will have to be removed off the field or he can bring another speed lead to guarantee turn one.
Yeah, let's see what happens here. As Reese is looking to wrap up his draft with this very last pick as the clock comes down here. I really hope we don't see a forced pick here. And we are going to be seeing a Raccoonie. I think Raccoonie's he's a fine unit here to bring in.
Yeah, I see a lot of fire, so that makes me think that Fallen Flower can bring a must-ban water unit and stick with his comp that looks very strong with a Hagan countering the strip, or a Verdahill as well. That tells us that maybe he's keeping this Chung Pung right here, and he might ban one of the sustain units or the turn one segment.
Yeah, it might be that turn one segment that gets banned out here, or potentially might be the Juno, because the Juno is gonna be bringing a ton of volatility against Falling Flower. We know how much additional damage is gonna be coming out of that. We know how long it's gonna be staying alive when you have that Laura, when you have the Cigar, when you have that Connell as well.
I would ban this Hey Gang right here. I think it just adds too much variance, so much trouble, but the Verge soaks up the ban, the Juno on the other side, and we're gonna see a turn one segment having to do some magic.
Yep, let's see what happens. Reese has the speed lead. He should be taking the turn one with a very fast segment, and he is going to be doing that exactly. Let's see who he chooses to reset here. More than likely that Laura.
Yeah, does he get it? Goes for the Cigar, gets the reset, and the Cigar, obviously because of the passive of Hagen, gets pushed up and takes the turn right now, which is great. He'll come out of that protection, goes for the more, forces the attack. Now the question is, does he want to push them up? Yes, sir. Doesn't get cut. The Raccoonie gets the turn, can give it back, to get some death breaks, some heel blocks. Glancing and the choke by Will push back. Beautiful play from Riz.
Yeah, that's incredible. Able to capitalize off all of these defense breaks that he has here. He can kind of go for any unit that he wants right now. Gets the attack break, a little bit more damage coming towards that Laura as well. Third skill is available going on the Kainal this time. It does get resisted though.
Yeah, it gets resisted, but he has a glancing. Very important. The reduction from the Moor was so key right here and gets us done. Moor so far shining the Raccoonie. One more proc. The Heigang can't do much right now, but gets a clutch stun on his brother, Chengpeng.
Heigang's just so good at those clutch stuns. Able to get that on top of the Chengpeng. Provoke trying to get landed on top of that segment. Not landing. He's got the big skill too. Not able to drop any units here, but I do think he's able to take out this Laura though.
Yeah, he goes for the damage. Oh no! It doesn't kill it. He can get some reduction right here, but he can finish the job with the Moor. Does he get greedy? That's a little bit greedy.
That's definitely a little bit greedy here. He's got to try and take out this Laura right now. Mm-hmm. When you have we've talked about this before. When you got an opportunity to take a unit out, you take a unit out. Does have skill 2 available. Does drop that Laura here. We have that Cigar who's stunned up right now, which is very, very good right now for Riz.
Yeah, he needs to remove the Cigar from the field because one of the strongest counters to the Moor, but the Moor has been dealing so much damage. So many turns this Raccoonie has given to his team, and the combo of the giving the turn back to the segment and to the Chengpeng has worked so well, and Riz takes game number 3, as we called it.
Yep, number 3, round number 3, going right to Riz. Well done, Riz there, really keeping Fallen Flower back.
Riz showing he deserves to be here at his first SWC appearance with the 1-2 combo there, Seppi.
Yeah, Evan, I'm just sad for him because he failed his desire. He wanted to win one game. Now he has 1-2, so, you know, he didn't win one.
The man's an overachiever. that's what we're seeing right now. We love to see it for Riz. This is a great debut for him.
And all of a sudden at match point, by the way. This could potentially be the last game of Riz versus Falling Flower.
Yeah, and remembering right now, he can't ban that Oliver, so he's gonna have that Oliver proposally like on turn 1, and he doesn't. He denies it. He says, Fallen Flower, you don't get the Oliver. He does get the combo, my friend, the Laura Wedget. You know, you take the Oliver off their hands, they're gonna play with it.
Yep, and I think the Oliver is definitely the right ban for Riz. You can't let that unit through. That's a very, very solid ban. Totally see that Sean being an excellent ban as well for Fallen Flower. Mm-hmm. We've got the Wedget being hit on the field already as a first pick for Fallen Flower. Riz looking to respond already. Let's see who he's gonna be bringing in here.
Yeah, if you know someone's bringing that wedge at Laura, the Juno becomes so much more important. You know, the Praha is a very important unit right here. We saw them perform really well. Brings the Juno instead of the Praha, the Shizuka. I also like that. So very good draft so far from both sides. We'll see if Fallen Flower brings over the Laura already or waits a little bit more with some mid-range units. The Chengpeng comes to mind since you don't have the reset from the Oliver. What would you like to see, Stoic?
I mean, I can't help but think that he's just going to be bringing that Laura once again with paired up with that Wedget. This is a combination that works really, really well. But I do think this is a combination Riz is going to be prepared for. I think the Julian is insane, though. I think this is a very, very good unit. A solid pick right here because this gives Riz a lot to think about right now.
And recently buffed, even stronger right now, all light comp. Is that what we're seeing? He can close it off, you know, with a Lauren and a Fran, just kidding, with a couple other very powerful light units. But he does leave the Chengpeng on the other side. Nope. I like this change from Riz. I like the Chengpeng, though. Okay. I really like the Chengpeng.
So what we have seen before, and we've seen this Dak Pure Vanilla do very, very well, it's always been extremely fast on all the times that we've seen this unit do well. So I'm curious to see the speed of this unit there because we've always seen it at such an incredible speed where it exceeded over his opponent.
Is that a Joe Gun in SWC together with my son? Your son is Aspires. My son is the Light Monkey King. Kitian Desheng making an appearance. Last pick now. You have to decide, do I want to play against this monster or can I bring a Fire Monkey and remove the damage from the field and try to survive with the Juno and the Fire Monkey? The Raccoonie comes to mind as well, but the segment turn 1 comes here. Does that telegraph, yes, that the ban is the Wedget? Yes, sir.
There we go. So the Wedget is going to get the ban right here. That Doc Pirvinel is going to get the ban as well. We've got a resistance lead coming out for Falling Flower and an HP lead for Riz. This could be match point.
Yes, sir. The segment is definitely taking that turn one. Can she reset? Dolores, does he go for the Monkey King? There's a lot of good options right here because he knows that the attack bar on the other side is very high. Increase cool time on her. What can he do? Nada.
Well, let's see what happens here with the second skill. Looking for some big trip. Beautiful despair stun, though, landing on top of that Julian.
You go for the reset. Skill three resisted on the monkey. Now he can put a unit away and go for the strip. Yes, the Juno is so powerful right here, so you want to try to remove her from the field, but he opts for the Chunk Bunk. Now, doesn't want to use the strip because he knows
Violet Jogun.
Yeah, very interesting. He knows that the Shizuka has the protection.
Yep, well, Shizuka with all skills available. We could see that skill too going right back to the segment to try and get cooldowns back up here. Off scope for that third skill, getting some stuns across the field. Curse of Beautiful is going to be landing. A lot of defense break, a lot of heal blocks coming out on the field as well. Looking for some big damage, but additional turns on the reset Laura.
Yeah, that's such a fast Laura. The stun on the Jogun was so powerful. Now there's no strip to set it up for the Kitian Dasheng. Here we go. Can he remove someone from the field in this turn and not leave an opening? This Julian is very, very low, but he has a passive that takes HP away from his friends, from his team, and keeps him alive.
I think he's got to put the skill three back onto the Light Monkey, but he chose to go back onto the Laura here. I think he was trying to get that big kill right there. It does have that dot leaning on top of that Light Monkey King. Oof.
Yeah, he trusts a proc right here. Doesn't die to the dot. A little bit greedy. I would have killed it as well. The Monkey King coming into play. You can even go for damage on the Juno. Yes, sir. And try to finish her off with the Laura. The Monkey getting one turn right there might have been a big deal.
He's got to take out that Light Monkey King here. Is there going to be any additional turn? No additional turns are going to be popping out. I think he actually goes to the skill two. He goes to the skill two, tries to get the kill.
Oh!
Is that...
A triple stun is what it is, my friend Stoic. Here we go. The monster is very low. He can just keep pummeling damage on the Julian, sucking it up from the other ones, and gets another stun. Salt in the wound. Can we already call Juno the MVP of this specific game?
Yeah, really. Juno is absolutely insane right now. The despair stuns are landing across the field. Julian trying to do all he can to get rid of that unit. Finally drops it right there. Of course, the Despair Sun sitting on top of our lower. No additional turns going to be popping out just yet here. We're going to get a full strip. Defense breaks landing across the field right now. Looking for attack bar reduction. Does get that on top of the segment. We're going to see some big damage with the skill two coming out onto the Chunk Punk, getting that the stun as well.
Yeah, you need procs with a Julian, but he hasn't gotten procs. He can't get the second skill back up quickly enough. A proc from the Shizuka finishing up little by little. Yes. I think that is, well, he will take a turn, though.
No.
Can he proc?
Push back here.
Can he proc?
He needs to proc.
No!
But he's got that skill, too, available. Keep in mind, Shizuka's got some big skills. Reese taking full control and taking down Bowling Flower.
It's Reese! Guys, give it up for Falling Flower and Reese. You're not going nowhere. You don't get away from this. Now, you told everybody you'll be happy if you win one match. So, are you an overachiever or
Yeah, I guess I'm an overachiever.